we start with two stories that'll impact just about every one of us. Summer clothes pushed aside for winter wear this week. And gas prices, how long will they stay at this level? Can they keep going down? Gas prices have been dropping for weeks. The average price here in the Twin Cities area was $3.36 last month. By last week, prices were $3.30 a gallon. Today, that's down to $3.28. Now, a year ago today, we were paying $3.54 a gallon on average. Are these prices the new normal, though? 5 Eyewitness News reporter Jay Coles caught up with an oil insider today, and he's live in Minneapolis to explain why prices are down. And Jay, is it possible they might stay low?
It just all depends, Leah, on who you talk to. That's what it comes down to. Right here at Metro Petro in Minneapolis, that's the price right there, $3.29, that you see around most of the metro, even across Minnesota. But there is an abundance of oil being produced right now around the world. So this begs a couple questions. Why isn't the price even lower, and will it continue to drop? These numbers roll up pretty fast and easy, and the weight of your wallet usually goes down just as easy. But gas prices over the past year have been a bit easier on your pocketbook, dropping quite a bit from a year ago. The top money guy at the American Petroleum Institute told us one reason is a sharp drop in crude oil prices worldwide.
Second of all, because we've had record production of gasoline and relatively weak demand because of a slow economy, you've had lower margins.
But I asked, with so much oil available around the globe and right up in the Bakken Flats of North Dakota, why aren't prices lower and will they continue to drop?
Well, it all depends on the economics. It depends on what the cost of the crude oil is versus the price you pay for the products that they produce. So the economics can be challenging, but it's possible.
John Felmy says the notion of peak oil is long gone. There's more oil out there than most know what to do with. So what does that mean for our economy with a planned billion-dollar oil pipeline snaking through northern Minnesota?
It's a wonderful opportunity for Minnesota to have an economic stimulus.
And in the end, Felmy says the near future of gas prices depends on what he says are three factors.
China, China, China. Basically, we have record demand for oil worldwide, so it's really going to be a function of those factors.
Now, Felmy tells me the Bakken Flats up in North Dakota, they are producing oil that is being turned into gasoline. Not a lot of it, but that gas, that oil, I should say, is being sent out east to be turned into gas. He said it's a supply and demand thing, but he said in the future, we could actually see it here in Minnesota in the upper Midwest, especially if that pipeline comes through. Reporting live in Minneapolis, Jay Coles, 5 Eyewitness News.